I'm so glad it's almost over. Congratulations, sweetie.
Thank you.
I'll never understand why you chose such a macabre field.
There's nothing disturbing about it. It's just that
I'm proud of you. I really am. You've come so far. So, you haven't told me what's next. Will you get a job where you are, or...?
They actually have everyone they need. But my old teacher, Mr. Delver, transferred me to his office to finalize my internship there.
Oh, well, that's good. I remember you mentioning him. Where's he located? Are you moving away from me?
No, I'm not moving. He's actually located around here. Riverfields.
Oh, Rebecca. I don't like that.
Grandma...
Even I've heard things about that place. I'd just be worried
people
about you.
People make up stories. Death is a scary thing to a lot of people. And we try to explain things we don't understand, and we want comfort when we lose someone we love. I mean, no one's embalming any ghost bodies or whatever. It's fine.
Right. I'm sorry. But I wanted to give you this anyway. So, here.
I don't know if I want that.
Just take it, please. It should be yours anyway.
Thanks.
All right, enough spooky stuff. I'm so proud of you. When is all this happening? When do you start?
I've actually been there for a few weeks now. My review is tomorrow. Here we go.
Rebecca. Great. Perfect timing. I just finished with Mr. Dalton here. Please wheel him back to cold storage and bring us Mrs. Page. I'm just finishing up something here, so why don't you grab the clipboard and start recording identifying marks? I'll get out of your way when you're done and let you hop in here. These old windows never stay latched. Great. Climb on in here and put everything into the record system. Don't forget to take the printout to the front desk so Zoe can add it to the packet for the family. After that, we'll get started. You'll die here.
What was that?
I didn't say anything. You all right?
Yeah. I'm fine. Sorry. Time to embalm.
All right. I've set everything out so you can just go ahead and get started. I'll be monitoring. Everything's on your list there if you need it.
There we go. All right.
Sometimes we get chemicals that haven't been stored properly, and it can make them pop like that. Just keep doing your thing. I'll get it.
There we go.
Tell you what.
What?
Why don't you go ahead and head out? I'll take over from here.
Are you sure? I just got here.
Don't worry. You're doing great. I'll get the last of your paperwork sorted today and call you in for your first shift.
It was just really weird.
So some stuff fell over. That's not a big deal.
No, I know. It wasn't even my fault, but he sent me home right after that. I'm just really worried. He was supposed to finalize my stuff today.
And he said he would, right?
Yeah.
So that's a good thing.
Yeah, it just didn't feel like he meant it. Like, he just said it to get me out of the building. Wait a sec, I have another call. Hello?
Hey, Rebecca. It's Raymond.
Oh, hi, Mr. Delver. Look, if I did anything wrong today, just...
No. I wanted to apologize. You've done a fantastic job. I'm just not feeling too well. That's actually why I'm calling. I know it's late, but we just got 3 new cadavers, and no one else can make it in right now. I was hoping you could come in and take care of them.
Well, yeah. Are you sure? I mean, of course.
Excellent. You are doing me a huge favor. I took care of the rest of your onboarding. We're all set. And your new badge is in your personal belongings drawer in the back room.
That's great. Thank you. I'm on my way right now. I hope you feel better.
Thanks again. I'll see you tomorrow.
Bye. Holy shit! That was him. He signed me on. He needs me to come in tonight.
See? I told you it was fine. Congratulations.
Thanks. I have to go, like, right now. I'll talk to you later. Where are my keys? Alright, guess I'll head to the back and get started.
Hi, Rebecca.
Mr. Delver, I need help. Someone's outside the mortuary.
Just try to stay calm. I know you're scared. I'll unlock the door in a moment.
What?
This is very sudden, but listen to me. We have to start right away. I'm sorry. I didn't know until it made itself known this morning that it was here, let alone bound to you. I had no way of knowing the possession had started.
What? Look, this isn't funny. Stop.
You need to take this seriously. You need to act quickly.
This is insane. I'll just leave. I'll just fucking leave.
You can't leave, Rebecca. I can't allow that for you or for others. It's far too dangerous.
What am I supposed to do then?
Most bodies I work with at night are fine. So we stay calm, okay? We embalm, file the paperwork, everything. Treat it like a normal day. Staying focused will help. I left some things for you on the desk. I'll call again when you get to the embalming room.
No, wait. Ugh, damn it, what the fuck? This is insane. Okay, this is so stupid. It's just some hazing for the new girl or something. Just play along and do your job. Quitting tomorrow. I mean, who does something like this?
All right, listen carefully.
I'm sorry, but this entire thing is extremely unprofessional. If this is how you treat new hires, I don't think I can work for you. This isn't funny.
Rebecca, you don't have to believe me, but I hope you do before it's too late. The only way to save yourself is to banish the demon before you're too far gone. To do that, you will need to learn the demon's name, bind it to its chosen body, and burn it in the retort. Look, I know this is a lot to take in. I wish I could do more for you. I had years to learn what I know. You have hours. I've recorded a number of cassettes to instruct you in the hope that having a physical object with a known message will help you stay grounded. I won't be calling again. You can't trust the phones. Anything can be manipulated. Listen to the tapes. Learn the demon's name. Burn the correct body. The most important thing in the room is in that cabinet. Open it up. Good luck, Rebecca. I'm sorry this had to happen.
This is insane. Whatever. Just professional one, grab a body, and get started. Yeah, screw all of whatever this is. I'm getting back to work. At least I can keep track of things. Shit out of me. Let's check you out. Hello? Nope, nope. New job. I'm getting out of here. I don't care how long I went to school. New career path. Fuck this.
Don't leave.
Fine. You don't want to. Maybe.
No.
Maybe everything's fine.
It's fine.
What?
No, I'm just saying things. I need to get back to work. It's fine.
Screw this. I'm getting back to work. So stupid. There we go.
I need to file the copy up front.
Time to embalm. There we go. Right.
The night shift database. A computer program combining all my findings into one reference point. The database contains all the information on the process of expulsion, the tools used, and most importantly, all the markings of the known demonic names. If you ever forget what to do, replay these tapes or look it up in the database. The collection of demonic names is the most crucial piece to the puzzle. You will need this information. My ID card is in my personal belongings drawer. On the back is the passcode to access it. Use it. Thank you.
Miss Callie.
Banish a demon to hell. It must be bound to its chosen body and burned. The three objects in this cabinet are your tools. First, the clay tablet in the center is called a mark. Placing the smaller pieces in the correct configuration will spell the demon's name. Second, the bottles on the top shelf are a special reagent that will react to the mark. Add a bottle to the embalming mixture during the process. When the mark is placed on the correct body, with the reagent inside, it will force the demon to become bound to it. Pay attention to signs that you have chosen correctly. They can be obvious or extremely subtle. Once you are certain the demon is bound to its vessel, burn it. Finally, the pieces of paper on the right are called letting strips. It must inscribe the sigils of its name in our world to begin the evocation. You will need to uncover these sigils to use them. Hold a letting strip up while wandering the mortuary. If it begins to smolder and burn, you're close. When the paper combusts, the sigil has been revealed somewhere in that area. They could be anywhere. So look on walls, under objects, inside furniture. Anywhere. The demon will inscribe its sigils over time to try and hide them, so check regularly. Once you uncover the sigils, use the night shift database to decide which demon you're dealing with, and use that knowledge to create the mark. The steps are simple. Add the reagent to the embalming mixture, uncover the sigils, build the mark and place it on the body. Then, when you're certain, burn it in the retort. At every moment, the demon is funneling its energy through you, weakening you, until you are unable to resist. Identifying a demonic entity is a delicate balance. The further you are from possession, the more time you have. The closer you are, the more the demon will make itself known, allowing you the information to guess its name and the body it's bound to. The only way I've found to tell how far along a possession is on your own is to scribble on a piece of paper. Don't think about it. Just scribble. Look carefully. If you notice anything strange, it's starting to take hold. There's a notepad and a pencil on the desk in the front room. Checking from time to time can give an idea of how long you might have.
I already have one of those.
There we go. All right. There we go. Hello?
Hello. Rebecca? Rebecca?
What the? There we go.
All right.
Missing something.
Oh.
What are you doing here?
There we go. All right.
There we go. There we go. Hello?
Hello? Why are you still doing this? I'm going to kill you, Rebecca.
I already have one of those.
great sorrow. I will claim the flesh of the man for my own. 3 houses and bowels of hell. 2 regions of glory of my house. 1 to usher tribulation. I have come.
Be more comforting.
Just let me hear, Rebecca. It will be over.
There we go. Thank you.
All right.
Jesus Christ. Rebecca. It's your grandma. I need you to let me in, sweetie. Don't you love your grandma? It's so cold out here. I'd love to come in. Let me in.
You little bitch!
Thank you.
sure this is the right one.
There you are. Good.
Is it over?
It's never over. But you survived.
What do you mean? Can I leave? I want to go home.
You can leave. But once an entity finds you, all the houses of hell will do anything to get back to you. I'm sorry, but it doesn't end here. From now on, there is always a chance this will happen again. No matter where you are.
I don't want this. I just want to leave. What do?
I'm sorry, but there's no going back. I've spent years learning everything I can to keep these entities at bay. It's the only thing we can do.
So what? You're waging some selfless holy war?
It's not a war. It's survival. And I'd hardly call it selfless. We're caught at the front line of something larger. But I don't do this for some greater good. We either face it, or fall to it. I wish I could claim to be someone better, suffering hell to save us all. But I simply want to live another day, just like everyone else. When I first experienced this, I had to make a choice. I could run and spend the rest of my days in fear, or I could learn to face it and keep some semblance of a normal life.
Normal. Right.
It's not a life I would want for anyone. But choosing between a life of fear or control. You're the first person I've met to face this hell and survive. so I'm offering you a different kind of job. Work the night shift. Learn what I know. Give yourself a chance at a life beyond fear. I don't know what you experienced, but I know it uses the worst parts of you against yourself. The more you experience, the more you'll confront the darkest parts of your life. But through it, you'll become unbreakable. I'm offering the tools to take control. The choice is yours. I hope you come back.